With Christoph, as I mentioned, our next contribution comes from Christoph Laduna, who works at the library of TU Graz and is a contact person of the TU Graz repository. He will highlight the library perspective on the TU Graz repository, which includes open educational resources and publications. And I will hand now the word over to you, Christoph.
Thanks. I will try to share my screen.
Great.
Did you see my screen?
Yes, we can see it.
Okay, perfect. So, what you have seen so far is that you might think that the repository of the TU Graz maybe consists of if not the case, we plan to incorporate also publications, theses, proceedings, digitization, e-journals, open educational resources, and we are open for new things, so we don't know what in the future there will be. For us, we decided. So there would be a possibility to use only the NVIDIA RDM data model, which is based on data set, but we decided to also create data models where the metadata would be Mark21 and Loon. Mark21 would be the metadata standard for records which are more associated with the library system, which will be ALMA, and Loon. Which is the Learning Object Metadata standard, will be the standard for the open educational resources. The thing is that we decided to do that in that way that we have also for Loom as an example to make it easier or more so that it's better to or easier to describe the metadata in a more specific way. Because some metadata fields are not existent in the dataset standard, like the target group, as example for Loom. And for the Mark21, the idea is that it's easier to interact with the library system, so all records which are in some way related to that will be stored in Mark21. So the status quo for Mark21, we have the possibility to create demo records or to create records. We can create records with files, and we can see a landing page for a record. It is it will it's so short one. It's possible to create such customized data models. It takes some times. It's also a little bit difficult to not difficult, but it takes some time to find out how it's possible to make it in a way that we are not reinventing the wheel. So we are reusing what the NVIDIA RDM is giving us, so we can profit from what CERN or what other what the community is doing. So that's the plan, and that takes some time to find out the right way. And for the Loom, we are now possible to create demo records and see almost the landing page. So that's also the reason why I don't show some nice pictures, because we are not yet finished or not in a state to show something. We are we are not that far away from that state, but not already there. So what our plan is to connect different systems with the repository, and we are using Mark21 for ALMA, for Pure, for Campus Online, and for OpenLib. And we want, I said before, that we want to have digitizations. There we have already a system, a running solution now that we write on our own. There is OpenLib. And that's already running for 10 years now, more or less. And there we have already the publications, the connection also to Pure, some connections to ALMA. And there we have the digitizations. We have also already the open educational resources there. But we all But we are planning and we are in the process of that to migrate all those informations to the new repository, which is based on NVDRDM. And we choose Mark21 also for the connection to Pure, because we want to have easier for those of the librarians who are interacting with those metadata, so that they have the same metadata standard as we have in ALMA. And one possible workflow would be, or what we plan to do, is that we can import the theses from the campus online system, that are the files and the metadata, then we create a record in the repository, then we have the possibility to associate a DOI with that, and then we move the, or the, we export the data, only the metadata, to ALMA, so that there we can create a record there, and the librarian could verify or validate the record in ALMA, and we put back the validated records to the repository. There's always a decision to take which system is responsible for the metadata, and in some ways, for thesis as example, would it be ALMA, but the files and the file management would be in the repository. And then we have OpenLib, where the most part is, will be to transfer, to migrate the data or the digitizations to the new repository. And the next one I talked earlier is the LOM, the Learning Object Metadata Standard, which is part, well, not it's part, but we there we have the, another project, the Open Educational Austria Advanced project, and there we are building, or some universities of Austria are building, an infrastructure for open educational resources. And for the TU Graz, we plan to connect the Teach Center, Tube, IMOX, which are software which is which we use on the TU Graz. There we have different use cases. We want to have on one way, on one thing is that the Teach Center will provide metadata and real files, real PDF files, or some other things. So we are open there, not only PDFs, but also text files and what the teacher, so there we are now on teacher side, what the teacher wants to make it open accessible. And the data will then be, the metadata and the files will then be in the repository. And for Tube and for IMOX, that's a little different use case, because there we have files and courses, so in Tube, videos. In Tube, there are videos, and we are not planning to move the data, to move the videos into the repository, but only a link to it. The idea there is, also for IMOX, is that we have one centralized system, the repository at the TU Graz, which is then serving the data to the, or exporting the data to the OER hub. And the OER hub is built by Uni Wien for the OER project, which is then the central discovery tool for open educational resources in Austria. And there we plan to use the OE PMH API, which is already done in the core from the core team, which is there. But we have to adapt the LOM data model to also use the OE PMH API, so that we can export the data over that. So our future plans for the rest, not for the rest, but which is not covered already, would be that we plan to have a connection to Cyverse and also to the MADMPs, which is the tool would be DAMAP, and then would be iRODS, and the other things are already mentioned, like Pure, ALMA, OpenCast, Campus Online. And we plan also to export our data, our digitizations, to our Piana. And we want also, as we have already in the current system, we have an export feature with OEPMH to export our publications which are coming from Pure, so the open accessible things, in the current system are only the open access publications, but in the future maybe more which are coming from Pure, but we want to export our open access publications also to OpenAIR. Yeah, that would be my presentations, and if there are questions, feel free to ask them.
Thank you, Christoph, for the library's perspective. We could go back to the question we previously had in the chat. Are all uploads done by the researchers?
Yes, in some ways. So in the sense for the publications. So there are two different things. For the research data, the upload will be done by the researcher. Researcher. For the publications like that, which is coming from Pure, there we have the CRIS system, which will be Pure, and the researcher will upload the data into Pure because it's necessary for other things, and then we will collect the data and import it automatically into the repository, and we will validate in some ways the data, because sometimes there will be problems with licenses and files and so on, so it's better to have a look at that. Mm-hmm. And for the Loom, for the OERs, there is the workflow that we have, the workflow that the teachers are uploading the files into the system I mentioned, like TeachCenter and Tube and IMOX, and then we are automatically importing it into the repository.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I don't know if this is already answered. Is there any moderation process from library staff?
For the publications, in some ways, yes. And for others, not yet. And for the Loom, we have there's the idea. The idea there is to have licenses, no, that we have a certificate for the teachers that they know what they are doing, and there's the idea there is.
Mm-hmm. Okay. There's another question. Can you display XML files with style sheets? I don't know if that's...
That would be a maybe more question to Lars about the preview, mm-hmm. but I think that's not the case yet, but it's maybe it would be possible to... Ah, okay, Mochip said yes, so mm-hmm. it's possible.
Thank you. It's good that you're in touch. Okay. When do you use which scheme data set? I'm not sure.
So for the research data, it would be data site for the publications, not for there are then the possibilities for the researcher to upload also publications. Those things are then stored by data site or with the data site standard. And the thing which are more librarian agnostic, they are then used, there we use the Mark 21. And for the all what is relying on open educational resources, that there we are then using Loom.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and can you switch in one repo from one to the other? Also switch between repos. I understand it like that.
No, that's one repo. That's we have one repo to use all standards in one repo. That's the idea behind.
Okay, and who decides which scheme will be used for a new record?
Good question. No, that's not really. It's the point is as an example for open educational resources, there would be a possibility to upload the data to. With the so the default standard is data site for the repository, and it would be possible to upload for everyone also open education resources. There we will implement a workflow where we can ask the person who is uploading that if they want to apply to the certificate. And after that, if the person wants to do that, the data is migrated to the Loom standard. And after that, it would also be possible to export it to the central discovery tool, to the OER hub, because we want also only export the data to that discovery tool if it's from persons who have the certificate. So it's not possible to create Loom without that we allow that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you very much, Christoph, for your presentation and for answering the questions. Thank you very much.